Dr. Dussler in 2009 signed the American College and University President's Climate Commitment, which was a commitment to carbon neutrality by 2050. Well, we don't want to settle for what everyone else is doing, so RIT set a commitment of 2030 with carbon neutrality. And our carbon footprint is largely tied to our energy consumption on campus, both our heating and cooling of buildings, but also largely our electricity consumption.
This unit will produce about 15 to 20% of our peak demand. It will be about 3% of our total commodity of electricity. So we expect it to produce that much, assuming we get a lot of sun and things like that.
In Rochester, while you know we focus on the gray weather here, Rochester has enough sunny days to really generate a decent amount of energy. And the efficiency of the panels is increasing to an extent where it's becoming economically viable. And you know, we're standing here in snow in the middle of winter as the panels are getting set up, and it's beautifully sunny, and the panels, if the power lines were yet connected, we're still waiting for that, but they would be generating pretty much at full capacity because it's the perfect angle for where the zenith is with the sun in the horizon right now is coming almost at a perfect angle for complete generation. So it's actually a good opportunity right now for us.
So this was offered to us by a firm that was able to get money from New York State to subsidize the solar array construction, and that allowed us to buy power from them at a cheaper rate than we can buy it from RG&E. So overall for us, it's a great effort in sustainability, but the effort really started from a sense of saving money for the university. And you know, overall, this is going to save money for the university for the next 20 years.
So this is a great next step and a very visible commitment, but it also makes financial sense. So it's really great in showing that triple bottom line for us about the economic, the environmental, and the social piece of it.